Hey everyone, it is, September 7th, and looks like we're heading to exactly the same area I was in yesterday for waterspouts, Southampton. And I will show you why. Before I do that, I want to say it's been a while since I had the butterflies for a setup, and I guess this is the first time I've had it all year in Ontario, and I'm happy, I guess, for that. But it looks like everything's coming together. The malls have been very consistent with the setup, and what I like about the setup, it's a very large area, so it's going to be chasers are going to be spread out, and whoever forecasts the best gets the best stuff, essentially. So I love those setups. Kind of reminds me of dryline setups in the south. Into it here. So I think most chasers, there's been a lot of hype about this setup, but I think most chasers think that it's basically going to be just a linear setup, but it's going to be a two-parter. First part, this warm front is going to initiate warm sector supercells, essentially. I'm thinking Grey Bruce County, so that's why I'm heading in this area here. So yeah, you're going to got daytime storms on the warm front. I have to keep an eye on the warm front very closely, because if it starts stalling, which it seems like here is a stationary front, it might, you know, start stalling like that. So then I'll have to go south. But and then, you know, later the cold front comes in, and that'll bring some, well, the infamous line of thunderstorms with the shelf clouds and all that stuff. Tornadic potential will be limited to the warm front, I think, today during daytime storms. If we take a look at right now, there's already ongoing storms in Michigan. So these are the warm front storms. Those are the ones that are going to be injected over Lake Huron. So that's basically what I'm going after. What else can I say? If we take a look at radar. So the Storm Prediction Center has a 2% tornado risk. I think it should be a little bit higher in Ontario, probably like a 5%. Every chaser and their dog is going to be out there today. Even though it's the first day of classes, it's potentially one of the better looking setups of the year. But I guess we'll see. I don't think it's going to be a bust today. I guess I might have just jinxed it, but I guess we'll see. We'll see. Yeah, it's going to be a very dynamic setup. Not so much. There's not very high dew points. It's not going to be a very, you know, like explosive day. Like, well, I guess we'll see. I'm not sure what's going to happen exactly. I'm hoping that we get the first round of supercells on the warm front, and then I'll be able to, closer to dark or after dark, I'll be able to get that line of storms on the cold front and then shoot lightning over Lake Huron. But that'd be a perfect day, I guess. We'll see what happens, but I'm excited because it looks like it's almost a sure thing of storms and thunderstorms and potential for storm chasing. So that's what I like. But also, these kind of setups usually see in August in Ontario or July with better thermodynamics, but with being a fall setup, there's better upper support, better dynamics. I have a little bit of the butterflies because I think there's going to be a lot more tornado reports that people are thinking about today, because these are the kind of setups that usually produce tornadoes in Ontario. But we shall see. Right now I'm in Elmira and I'm heading towards the Lake Huron shoreline like everybody else is doing, but I'm probably going to end up in Southampton. Hoping that everybody sticks to the south, the Goderich area or Sarnia area, but I guess we'll see. So we're slowly making it to our target area, and well, this is what's happening. There's just a bunch of traffic because it's first school day out, construction everywhere. So I'm just trying to get to the shore and have a look at this storm over Lake Huron. But basically, so far it's happening pretty much on schedule. The warm front storms, and then later on we'll get some cold front storms. So, give you an update once we get to the shoreline. So, made it to Southampton here on the shore. Got a big shelf cloud right behind me. I'm gonna flip it. You can see there's a pretty massive looring right back here. All the way, goes all the way back there, which I think people in Port Clark might see the southern edge of this, but I'm more interested in the looring that's happening right in front of me. The storm is definitely building here. That looks great. So, a little update here. Shelf cloud is getting closer. It's down here. It's pretty obvious. I'm shooting time lapse. Hopefully it will be nice. There's a lot of lightning and there's rotation on radar right in this location here, which is to be expected because the whole thing's pretty much rotating. But more interested in what's happening back there. That's like the edge of it, essentially. It goes all the way here, up here. So I'm at the absolute northern edge of this. Now we just gotta wait. It comes by and then I'll have to essentially shoot east-southeast, try and stay ahead of it. But it's 4 p.m. now, so it's definitely probably the storm of the day. Not sure if there'll be a potential for storms after this now, because this is pretty substantial storms here that would essentially take all the environment. The way I talk, guess I got it from a byproduct of a kneeling down in a town where the doors don't lock. And there's a million other people like me from a scene a little more poke, dunk, and pop. I didn't choose being born in the sticks, and I'll be damned if I sound like something I ain't. For some folks, a back road gets old, but for me, it just can't. 'Cause I'm from a small town, southern draw crowd. We sipping clear, drinking beer on a Friday night. Every country girl got on a cutoff, shaking her hips, take a trip. Buddy, tell me I'm a liar. So circle up big trucks around a fire. Still kicking up some dust behind the tires. Call it cliche, but hey, just take it from me. You're still going down out in the country. Closer. Looks like there might be wannabe wall cloud forming right there on the right. It's pretty big. Southampton again. So there's no way that there's not something that gets spun up by this. So the inflow winds have increased. Again, textbook supercell rotation right here. It's rotating hard. This thing's about to eat me, so I'll have to leave pretty soon, but it looks like there might be... Well, there's something definitely rotating right there. Just a gorgeous, gorgeous storm. Definitely a storm of the year right here.
Yeah, it looks nasty though.
I think it's gonna be run.
I think you have about 5 minutes to take a few pictures and run. If that.
So, storm is essentially on me now. It's pretty epic. I need to blast, get the hell out of here. Aerial rotation is still over here. Swear one Bud Light sip and I buzz back. One Jack and Diane, I'm in the past. Lost in the middle of 17. Yeah, everything about you and me.
was a tank of gas and a radio song. Down to the right and sing along. One busy kiss, girl, I was gone. Your hand up under my shirt, it still feels like it's right there. Windshield harsh midnight air. Any good thing, it don't last long. Like a tank of gas and a radio song.
Trying to evade the rotating storm, but the traffic is just not good.
That dashboard blue on your skin, that fire, that touch, that wild, that rush, yeah, that was us running down a high. Wish all it took to go back in time was a tank of gas and a radio song. Down to the right and sing along.
I think there's a developing tornado right in front of me.
Windshield harsh midnight air. Any good thing, it don't last long. Like a tank of gas and a radio song.
Still rapidly rotating. Something.
Tornado imminent on the right side.
That fire, that touch, that wild, that rush, that high, that I'm still on.
That I'm still on.
Was a tank of gas and a radio song.
Down to the right.
Was a tank of gas and a radio song. Was a tank of gas and a radio song. Down to the right and sing along. One busy kiss, girl, I was gone. Your hand up under my shirt. It still feels like it's right there. Windshield harsh midnight air. Any good thing, it don't last long. Like a tank of gas and a radio song. Tank of gas and a radio song. Tank of gas and a radio song.
Hail fog coming off the fields. There's junie size hail. We're just south of Payton right now. So there's so much hail that fell here. Basically looks like you got it snowed. And this is big hail too. It's quarter size hail.
Thank you.
old LGO. Snake on my back.